In this video, we will try to understand how can we generate test data for testing purpose. Now, during testing phase, what happens is you would like to generate range of test data so that you can test your application. And most of the times, testers end up doing monkey testing or exploratory testing. In other words, you know, they start hitting the application with various permutations and combinations of data to see if the validations are appropriate or not. Now, you know, this is fine, you know, if the tester is very smart enough to figure out all the permutations and combinations, but if not, then probably, you know, there can be some left outs. So if we can have some kind of automated way by which we can provide the validation, and then using the validation, if you know, we can have some kind of a system, you know, which can generate test data for us, you know, that would be much better. So in this video, we will see that how can we generate test data, you know, by using the SQL Server database project. So let's take a simple example here. Let's say we want to generate test data for invoice numbers. So let's say that we have an invoicing application and we would like to generate test data for invoice numbers. And there are two, you know, validations, or I'll say restrictions, on the way the invoice number data should be generated. First thing is that the invoice number data should always start with INV, and the rest of the part of the invoice number will be numeric. So in other words, you know, you can have, for example, probably, you know, you can have something like this. You can say, you can have data like INV 1001 or INV 2003. So in other words, the invoice number should always start with INV and the rest of the part should be numeric. Okay. And the second validation or the restriction is that invoice number should be in the length or in the range, you know, of 4 to 8. In other words, the minimum length of invoice number can be 4 and the maximum length can be 8. Now you as a tester would like to go and generate range of dummy data so that you can test, you know, if your application is you know, is able to match these validations. Now the one way of doing it is just open the application and start doing monkey testing, you know, start saying, okay, INV1, INV1002, INV2004, and see that if the validations are working or not. Or the next thing is go and use some tool to generate test data so that, you know, you can test the application properly, you know, you can test in no time, and most important is that, you know, you can test accurately, because it's possible that you can leave some permutations and combinations when you're doing monkey testing. So we have a very nice tool, you know, given by SQL Server, or I'll say Visual Studio, I'll say rather, not SQL Server, a nice tool given by Visual Studio called as the data generation project, which can be found in the SQL Server project. By using that project, you know, we can provide these validations and we can generate test data. So let's start doing the practicals. So the first step is, let's go and create a very simple database, you know, where we will go and store our test data. So let me go and create a simple database here called as test data database. Okay. So this test data database will have, you know, tables, you know, which will store our test data, which is generated, you know, by the tool. And in this test data database, let's go and create a very simple table here called as invoice data. Okay, invoice test data, so that, you know, we can store the invoice test data into this table. So what I'll do is I'll just create a very simple field here called as invoice number. And let me give this as varchar of 50, varchar of 50 for now. And let me save this table and let me give the name as TBL invoice test data. So now what we'd like to do is, or what we'd like our tool to do is, you know, this table TBL invoice data, we would like to go and fill this table with lots of, you know, test data, you know, with the validations which we have decided, or the validations which we have just discussed. So we would like, you know, this TBL invoice test data should be filled with, you know, test data, you know, invoice number test data which we have discussed, you know, as per the validations. So let's see how we can do that. So in you know, for the same, what the first thing what you do is, let's go to Visual Studio, let's click on this database project here, let's click on SQL Server, and let's click on the SQL Server 2008 project wizard, and I'll give a name here saying data generation. Okay, and let's say okay. So let's do a next here. So now you have popped up with the wizard, so let's start filling this wizard. So let's do a next. Let's keep all these things as it is, even the same here as it is, and let's say that yes, I want to go and import my existing schema here. So let's go and create a new connection. So let me provide your localhost, and the database name is currently test data database, Let me just test it. Let's say OK. And let's say next. And yes. Let's keep all these default things as it is. And let's say finish. So once you do that, you know, it will create your database project. It will import the database schema. You know, it will do a lot of things over here. You know, but our interest at this moment, because when we talk about a SQL Server database project, it has a lot of things you can do with that. But our main intention of doing this practical is to generate, you know, what you call test data, right? Now you can see that, you know, there is a, you know, once this solution is created, right, you can see that there is a very nice folder here called as data generation plans. And that's what is our main intention, or that's what we are going to do in the next coming 2 or 3 minutes. So let's right click on this data generation project, add new item. Now you can see that, you know, there are various templates over here, you know, which help you to do certain activities. And one of the templates, you know, which we would like to use for this current thing is this data generation plan template, right? So click on this data generation plan template, and let's give a name here saying invoice number DGEN, okay? And let's say add. Now once you have created the DGEN file, you can see, you know, some kind of a screen like this on your Visual Studio. The top section actually talks about the type of table, or I'll say, you know, the table structure, and the below section actually talks about, you know, how is the data, you know, how the data will be generated. For example, if you see over here, it's saying that currently it's using string for data generation. In other words, if I right click and say preview data generation over here, you know, you can see that it is randomly generating some data over here, which is of 50 character long, and basically, you know, trying to give you some data out. Now this doesn't make any sense for us. We would like to generate test data, you know, with the validations we have discussed, you know, when we started this video. So if you remember, right, we talked about two validations of invoice number, and we would like to use those validations to generate test data and not just some random test data over here, right? So in order to go and control how the test data will be generated, you can see that there is a small field here called a generator, and you know, you can see that there is something called as regular expression here. So by using regular expression, you can go and define, you know, how the data will be generated, and then accordingly, you know, the data would be shown in your column here. So let me go and select regular expression. So now let's start defining our regular expressions for our invoice number. So let me go to properties here. And now in case you are new to regular expressions, what I will suggest is please do go and see our video on regular expression, where we have it's a 30 minutes video, you know, where we have shown how to use regular expressions, how to use you know, basically you know, what are the different attributes in regular expressions, and how to basically go and do validations. So I'm not going to go in depth in this video talking about regular expressions. You can watch our video on questpond.com, which is what are regular expressions and how to use them. So currently, let me just start writing my regular expression here. So first thing is, I said that we would like to start, you know, first thing is the total length of the invoice number will be 8, that is maximum length, and the minimum will be 4. And it should always start with INV, right? So I'll give a square bracket here and say that always start with INV. Now if I go and do a preview data here, you can see that it's starting with INV, you know, but it's basically, you know, just giving me one character that I don't want that. I want all the whole thing to be there, right? So I'm going to say here, I'm going to just remove the square bracket here. Now let me just test it. So that's right, everything is INV. Good. Now the next thing we would like to do is, we would like to say that after the INV, you know, we would like to have numbers. So because we said that, if you remember, right, the validation part we talked, we said that the invoice number will always start with INV, and the remaining part of the invoice number will be a numeric, will be numerics, right? So I'm going to say okay, after this it should be always be numeric, enter. So it can be any number between 0 to 9. Now let me go and do a preview data here. I can see, yes, good, nice, it is generating some test data here, and I'm happy about it, right? Now we also said that the maximum length of invoice number has to be 8. In other words, already this 3 length is already occupied, so the rest of the 5 should be numbers, right? So in other words, the maximum length is 8, and the first 3 characters will start with INV, right? So what we'll say is, we'll say that okay, that means the rest of the number generation can be maximum is 5 characters, right? And let me do enter here, and if I do a preview, you can find that it is now generating random data, you know, which starts with INV, and generates a 5-digit numeric after that, and the total length is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nice. So we are achieving our goals. Now hang on, we also did say that, you know, the minimum length, you know, has to be 4 characters, or minimum length should be 4. So in other words, the first 3 lengths are already occupied by INV. So what we can say is that, okay, generate numbers with length 1 as well as with length 5. Okay, so now if I do a enter here and I do a preview data, now you can see that, you know, the minimum length is 4 here, the maximum here is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, then there is something with length 4 here, then again with some other length here, 5. So now you can see that, you know, we have different permutations and combinations of test data generated, and now we can take this test data and fire it to a unit test. We can take it to a, take this test data and fire it probably onto a coded UI test or wherever we wish. So I hope that, you know, this tutorial was useful. In this tutorial we saw that how we can go and generate random test data by using the data generation plan. Thank you very much. Now whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.questpond.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered, so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.questpond.com if you're interested. And you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. In the same way, you know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.